Yo, what's up? It's your girl, Brittany Renee, the mother effing smoke, and you're watching Team Rich TV. Who is Brittany Renee? Brittany Renee is a plethora of different personas in one that just explodes into this big, fat, beautiful artistry. What do? I am a singer / rapper.
Fucking smoke, man.
Brittany Renee.
Call somebody trying to talk to him, cause I ain't really trying to talk to him. Got it on my mind, I wanna murk a bitch. Can't find a ride that I'ma walk to. Better tell a bitch I got it out for. A bitch drop the eddy and I out. Put a big hole in this bitch body. I'll fuck around and I'ma walk.
Been more so focusing on singing nowadays, but you already know I am the fucking smoke, so smoke can come from anywhere. And I am from Port Arthur, Texas, representing till I'm dead.
That's right, come and get me right with a backside, make me act right. Had you missing when I was your bitch last night? I can tell you ain't got to wild out in a while. You want it super soaking through the mattress, baby, I got it.
This single is not for my project. I'm actually a feature on this most recent single, I Can Doll featuring Brittany Renee. But it was a really, really big, in our community, it boomed really hard. We're sitting at like, 57K in views. We got a lot of shares, a lot of likes. So I want to send a shout out to a Facebook group that I'm a moderator in, Stud Empire. We got a lot of our fan base from there. It's a group on Facebook. It's actually pretty successful. It has around 97,000 followers. So it's actually pretty big in the community or whatever. And they're doing some great things, a lot of great projects, programs, things of that nature. So I am coming out with a song with Whip the Rapper. I hope to work with. I do want to work with Kayla. She's pretty dope. She's hard. She's real hard. I like her. I like her delivery. I like her content. P.A. Youngin is going to be on this project. So y'all be looking out for that. We did a little bit of promo for that one record, but definitely we're going to come out with something with P.A. Youngin. I Can Doll. I was featured on her project, but actually she reached out to me, and That's really how the bells and whistles started, you know, coming about with working with other artists in my area. Shout out to my girl Courtney. She will also be on the project in some way, form, or fashion. She has no choice. Courtney, you have no choice. But we both share the same manager, Eric Mindset. Shout out to my manager. I feel a lot more comfortable on stage. I feel a lot more confident in my content and what I have to say. And just really accepting my reaction from the crowd and making that reaction from the crowd. It's starting to pick up, like, to where they're starting to know certain words and certain things. So that's a real, real good feeling. That's a dope feeling. Yeah, so I'm much more confident on stage now. I can't go nowhere without hearing Brittany Renee or the motherfucking smoke or all that. And everybody just, I don't know, that just stuck. I don't know why, but hey, that's what it is. I am actually signed to Sony Orchard. It's I Love Music. And just a lot of connections that I've made with you know, being signed as an artist. And my initial single is Chopper, featuring Huey, the guy from Pop, Lock, and Drop It. He's really, really dope. I've actually been performing that record more and more, and we're about to start doing a lot of promo for Hot Girl. It's basically like a remake of the original, featuring BWA Kane and Swag Jazz. A lot of features in the video, a lot of pop-ups in the video. Shout out to the Double Dose Twins. They are some real avid supporters of my movement. Actually, we didn't fly out. We didn't fly out nowhere. We went and rode. We drove that whole 13 hours. The road is always fun, though. Like, it's always dope to be on the road with Eric. It's just, you know what I'm saying, us, probably another driver, somebody, and I'm just back there riding and smoking, blowing, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's always a good time on the road. How is balancing personal life and the music? It's really, really tough, especially if you're serious about it. But I treat it like it's not a job to me. Like, I treat it like it's just naturally a part of my day, naturally a part of my life. my daughter's a part of it. You'll see her at the studio or in a video. She was in Good Damn Day with her dad, like where we all just vibing. Like it's all a one big family movement. So she's a part of everything. So and just, you know, really just putting out the projects that I do. Like it's all about my life as a mom and artist. So you'll, in this project more so, you'll get to see and hear more of that. I usually put a lot of my personal self in my music. I usually put a lot of who I am and what I'm going through. I'm one of those artists. Like I have to get this out artistically. So you've heard me mention Gotti a few times. Gotti was a someone that I was dating briefly, who I was in love with at once upon a time. And they were just one of those people that, you know, that come around and you just become addicted to that person. And when you know, you have to detox yourself from that person, it always hurts. So I ended up putting her in a lot of, I will not say her name. But in a few of my projects, I play in Games cover by Summer Walker, and 3 months later I did mention her because that was someone that I really was in love with. And the whole process of having to detox from that person was something that I had to put in song. Honestly, since that situation, I've been focusing on myself and my music more, my imagery, how I come across to people, my personal relationships. So I won't say that I don't have time for a relationship, but as far as my music is concerned, I don't have time for a relationship. So yeah, as of right now, I'm single. Yeah, now I am starting to focus more on marketing myself. Because I have a lot to market, you know, I have a lot of great angles with me, you know what I'm saying, my looks, personality, and I want people to really purchase that, you know what I'm saying, like to really understand who I am and really want to have that in their home, you know what I'm saying. What happened in the situation when I was followed around the store? Honestly, as a black woman, you hear that a lot. As a black person, you hear that a lot, like people get followed around the store. But until you experience it, you don't really understand how much it hurts. Like, I was in the store with my daughter, and I'm having to have a conversation with my four-year-old that this is how people perceive her. So what happened was, we were walking through the store, and the salesman, whoever, he was following us noticeably, but I didn't realize that it was, like, I just thought he just ended up being wherever I was. But when I realized that he was trying to fix a perfectly aligned row of hair products, I was like, you're following me. And my daughter's confused, and just to have to explain that and to have to really just explain to her how she's already prejudged as a black person, a black woman, that's the part that hurt. We as America have always been some damn bullies. But honestly, everybody know how I feel about that situation. 45. I would never support his campaign or any of his politics. There are certain things that ended up working out for the good, because I hate when people give me this argument when it comes to him, to protect him as far as, you know, black people and the housing market and everything of that nature. Like, if anything black is being helped in politics, I usually think that it's for some type of monetary gain. I could be a conspiracy theorist. I could be an idiot, but I really don't think, for a system that's designed for us to fail, I don't think that anything done in government towards black people is ever genuine unless it has something to do with monetary gain. So, I mean, as far as the war that looks like is stirring up right now, I just want to send my prayers to our troops and my prayers and my love to their families. I have family in the military. That's right, around this time last year, he was shutting down the government and shutting down jobs, and now we're in a whole war. Great job, 45. Yeah, next question. Honestly, there was someone that I wanted to address. Her name is Safari Marie, and there was an incident last night, and I just wanted to say that, baby girl, I'm glad that you did not succeed, and the world is a better place with you in it. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's the motherfucking Smoke, letting y'all know that you have been watching Team Rich TV.